41-foot Gulfstream diesel pusher just landed here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. This is a member of the very rare, actually, Atrium Edition, which in the main seating of the slide, it's just windows and skylights, and it's just nothing but light. It's a very uncommon feature. It's actually something I'd only seen in, like, brochures and things before. Like any diesel pusher, we've got a, you know, your front generator runs like a charm. It was running right before I came out here. Actually, we're charging up the house batteries. Full basement belly storage. Front tires were replaced last year. Rear tires are fair. I think that's just the best way I can say it, is that overall they look okay. I see just the beginning of a little bit of usage and weather checking on them, but they look fine. Last year they discovered there was a small leak above the skylight in the shower, though that's been fixed. I don't really see anything there that scares me. 65,000 miles, so they actually got some good use out of it. That's one of the things people don't consider a lot of times on motorized RVs, is not enough miles is just as bad, if not worse, than too many miles. I do like the double awning on this, though. So you got an awning that comes all the way back here. Then you have a second armless awning that actually goes over that atrium slide. So if it is just a sunshining day and you don't want to feel like an ant under a magnifying glass, you can roll the extra awning out a little bit to give you some room for that. Double power entry step makes coming and going pretty darn easy. Other than, I don't know, it could use a cleaning. Let me shut the door behind me. That's about it. I mean, other than that, it's pretty fair in here. Now, they have done a little bit of furniture swapping, which is pretty plain to see. That table, that residential-looking dining table setup, that was not the original factory setup, but it looks fine, you know. The original chairs, as much as they use this, they probably wore out some of the original furniture, and I'm glad that they replaced it rather than leaving old junk here. So this super slide right here with the twin recliners, you can see that there's a lot of different things you could do with it. You could arrange furniture however you want. And look at that thing. I mean, show me another time you've seen something like that in here. That just lets a flood of light in here. Plus all the extra mirrors and things help reflect plenty of light around. Now we've got as you would expect in something like this, a soft touch noise canceling ceiling liner, so that you know, you have a quiet trip going down the road, as well as a quiet destination when you get there. Very common motorhome, diesel pusher, kitchen here, plenty of overhead storage. It's kind of compact, but it's also extremely deep, so there's a ton of storage in what looks like a very small space. Those solid surface counters hide things pretty nicely below them. Front entertainment here has been updated from the original, like, not tube TV, but you know what I mean, the old style big boxy TVs, for a more modern flat screen setup. Not really much else to say up front here. Like I said, it's simple, but it's nice. It's clean, it's effective, it's what it needs to be. Dual air conditioner, obviously. Full hydraulic leveling system, which is a nice feature. So when you get to your destination, it will take care of you. I think I mentioned about 330 horsepower Cummins diesel. We have Allison transmission, which the one pretty much almost always goes with the other, but I thought I'd mention it just in case. That's a 10 cubic foot gas electric fridge freezer, and this actually has a very nice generous pantry space. You don't usually get big wide pantries like that in anything either towable or motorized, so I mean, take it where you can get it. This has a feature I've kind of seen before. This big window right here, as you come into the bathroom, it kind of sets the attitude for a rear office environment, you know, like a little home away from home writer's nook or something like that. It seems like this window kind of always associates with that, to give it that sort of like office or den sort of feel to it. So up here, again, they had a leak. It's been resolved. You can see a little bit where maybe some of the ceiling liner adhesive has been affected, but overall, it was so brief that obviously it didn't even, like, stain anything. So whatever it was, they took care of it quickly. The sink here, very large, so you can actually get big adult hands into it. Drives me nuts when I see these little, like, pop-up size sinks in a big diesel pusher like this. Very private bath area, although I do like the extra linen cabinet space they have dedicated for in here. Anytime they can give you anything extra, I do like that. Now, let me flip up the little footlock here, but we can add a stackable washer dryer here if you are so inclined, and it does look like at some point someone had done that, although at some point it had also been removed. The less than 2% of the RV world
actually installs a washer dryer. And this is one of those examples of someone who did it and found out it's just maybe not for me. They don't work extremely well in a lot of cases. I know that when you are full timing, and I know that the idea of a public laundry service isn't always ideal, so I don't fault anybody for, you know, not utilizing an RV washer dryer or for utilizing one, but generally speaking, they don't work out for a lot of folks. Big rear storage here, and that's one of the best things on this. If you're going to be in something long term, you're going to like all that extra storage. And this is a extra slide over here. So this is slide number what, 3 of the coach. It's pier storage and entertainment, but you also have that nice little desk space right there. So when you reach your destination, if you need to do a little bit of laptop work or anything like that, you've got the perfect little office area to do it. And there's one of those classic TVs I was mentioning, and you're getting a wonderful shot of my legs currently. I like the 6 dresser drawers in that closet too. Can't quite see them all from this angle, but you get the idea, I'm sure. The mattress, obviously a true queen, that, and it's a residential bed, not a normal camper bed, but I love these little nooks. I love it whenever they utilize the bedroom like this in something. There's a brand of toy hauler that we carry here at Haylett RV that kind of has like a full master suite in the back of it, kind of like this. It's something that, or in the front rather, something I enjoy. Anyway, I'm rambling. So this has been a quick flyover view of this thing. You know, there's a lot, every person has a unique, different set of questions. There's no way I could ever put a video together that answers every one of those questions. My goal here is to give you an idea. Is this something you think could work for you? If you do, give us a call. We'll walk through it, take it on a test drive, whatever you need to be comfortable with it, pull it up to the building, hook it up to water, power, whatever. That way you know exactly what you're getting with it. And after that, understand we only do everything, whether it's pieces, parts, financing, trades. You know, we can, I mean, we'll take horse trailer and on trade on something like this. We do just about everything here at Haylett RV. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.